Hey everybody, it's Buddy and Madison back here with first-time RVers. We're taking a day trip today to Beaufort, North Carolina. Quaint little town right on the ocean. As you can see, it's pouring down rain, but it is supposed to stop in a couple hours here, so with any luck, we'll have a decent day. Stay tuned and come with us to Beaufort, North Carolina. So here we are in Beaufort. You can see behind me some pretty historic homes. And then there's a lot of waterways here before you get out to the ocean. And then behind me here, you got all these boats that'll take you out to the islands and give you tours and things like that. The weather's getting better. It's not raining anymore, but it's still cloudy. But you can see there's a lot of people have done their boats up like pirate ships. There's another small one right here. There's another one out there. Hopefully everyone can hear me pretty good. I didn't bring my microphone. Dumb me, huh? You can see people just sit out here in their boats. Look at this houseboat. I mean, that looks like something someone made. And then these islands, it's just filled with little islands. I think this one right out here is called Carrot Island, if I'm not mistaken. And there's wild horses on several of these little islands. And then beyond here, I think it's a good 20-minute boat ride out beyond this island, is Shackleford Island, which is a pretty big island. It's uninhabited like most of these are, but they do have like the wild horses. And that's one of the main islands you can take these ferries out to. We're here with my daughter's Girl Scout troop. My wife and I are actually gonna celebrate our anniversary, but my daughter's gonna be on this Crystal Coast lady here to go on some tours. Not sure how many of you know about the eyeglass crab, but it's a very rare crab, and I happen to see one down here in the water. And there he is. The eyeglass crab. These cool little benches made out of the old, I don't know what you call those, where they wrap the rope around on a ship. It's like they're dancing. So I finally see some of the wild horses out there. Unfortunately, they are really far away, right where that boat is passing. As soon as he passes, right behind there. You see him? Or two or three horses. A lot of the homes are marked with their years and I guess some of the original owners. Anyone looking to restore a home in a beautiful little town? Here's one ready to be worked on. A few fireplaces. Double-decker porch. Not too bad. So here we are at the old burying ground. Deeded to the town in 1731. There are a lot of Revolutionary and Civil War soldiers buried in here. So we'll take a look around. So as with a lot of churches and cemeteries and stuff, they invite you to come in and look around, but they ask for donations. We put our dollar in the box there. As you can see, you can download a tour. But I mean, some of these are ancient. And they're numbered, as you can see here, And then you can follow along. It appears you can follow along on your phone now. There's a lot of them here, and I wonder if people like try to do research or what, but here's one here that the headstone's now missing. Born in 1782. Another unmarked grave of several people here. Here lies the remains of the settlers killed during the Tuscarora Indian War, 1711. I mean, just think of the history here. British naval officer buried standing in salute to His Majesty, King George III. It's just amazing. But this is a grave of a girl whose family came over from England. And as she got a little older, she always wanted to go back to England. So her dad convinced her mother to allow him and her to go back to England. And he promised her that he would bring their daughter back safe. Unfortunately, she passed away on the boat ride back. So her father bought a barrel of rum from the captain and put her body in the barrel of rum to preserve her, to bring her back to her mother. And she's supposedly buried in that barrel of rum in this grave. So over the years, as you can see, people have come by and visited and just started to bring things that you would bring to kids, whether it be toys, or there's Ben and Jerry's coupons sitting there. Here's another old home in Beaufort. 1778. So we're here at Beaufort Historic Site. And according to this North Carolina Civil War Trails info here, it says inside that old burying grounds, there's soldiers from the Confederate and Union Army and graves of slaves and free blacks. So that's a lot of American history in one cemetery. I don't know if you all can see, but look at the old, I'm sure that's cedar plank roof. But look at the amount of moss growing on that thing. That is just cool. Here's the pharmacy, or as it was called back in the days, the apothecary. Not sure when the last time this smokehouse was used. Evidently it was given to Beaufort by the NC Port Council. But I opened it up. Of course you can see it's just a bunch of stuff in there. But man, I mean you can see the charring on here. And you can smell, still smells like smoke. I don't know when the last time it was used, but wow. Very strong smell of smoke. So Beaufort, North Carolina. What is it known for? Well, I guess it's not really known for much, but it is the county seat. It is the third oldest town in North Carolina. It's obviously waterfront with these inlets all behind me and then the ocean behind that. Couple other significant events. Blackbeard. Queen Anne's Revenge. Anyone hear that ship? It went aground here in Beaufort in 1718, I think I read. So what else? Well, I showed you the old burying grounds, and there's a few homes here all on the Federal Registry of Historic Places. And one other thing is Budget Travelers Magazine readers ranked it as number one best small town in the country back in 2012. So everyone, thanks for watching. We'll see you soon. Hope you enjoyed it.